AFTV DT 2-0 to Arsenal. It didn't look like being that for long periods of that game because Newcastle made it really, really difficult. Everybody behind the ball, low block, what we thought they'd do, low block, everyone behind it, and we couldn't break it down. But it all changed when those substitutions were made. Smith Rowe, Saka, Lacazette, they're the three that have made the difference. And we're through to the next round.
Yeah, I would also include Granit Xhaka in that as well. Yeah, in terms of making the difference. He was excellent when he came on. And we finally had somebody that actually played the ball forward and was trying to break up the lines that Newcastle were using to put the blocks in place. And let's be real as well, though. Bern Leno kept us in the tie right at the end of the game.
That chance at Andy Carroll. Oh, the save. Well, Andy Carroll missed the sitter.
Yeah, he missed a sitter, but that was way before. I mean, right near enough the last kick of the game. And it wasn't just one, it was the reaction as well. Absolutely outstanding. And that justifies why he had to play and not Runnison.
Yeah.
So let's think about, you know, in that respect. But if Newcastle would have won that game, that would have been just an absolute travesty for football in general, because I can tell now why the Geordie faithful are so fed up with what they're seeing. Because that is honestly just awful. And I feel that Steve Bruce probably handed us the tie with taking Andy Carroll off.
Yeah.
I was very...
He wasn't afraid, wasn't he?
I was very, very surprised. You know, he was winning everything. Defensive headers, attacking headers. You know what I mean? But like you said, the substitutes made a big difference to the game. I felt that they added a drive and an impetus to our play that we've seen over the last three games that we've been winning. And what I saw before that were the players that were not performing before, you know, we went on the winning, you know, say winning run. It's four games in a row now. But since before that Chelsea game, what I saw were players that were playing safe passes. You know, 5-yard stuff, just simple, no real energy, no real drive, just trying to plod along and go through the motions. And I know that you were saying beforehand that you felt that Willian didn't do too bad. And in comparison to some of the other players on the pitch, I agree. But when you then brought Emil Smith Rowe on and saw what he does in the number 10 position, it shows you how poor Willian actually was.
Yeah. None of those players that sort of came in, did themselves, you know, none of them have said to the manager, yo, I need to start against Crystal Palace.
No,
Cedric,
no.
Willian, Pepe, you know, none of them have put, you know, Willock, none of them have put an argument forward to say, I should start.
Look, the players that we took out of the side to put on the bench, like Smith Rowe, Lacazette, Saka, not one of them will have a sleepless night before Crystal Palace.
No. Xhaka as well.
Just honest to God, nobody's going to have a sleepless night because they start all day. We can name the team now for Crystal Palace. We might as well just do the preview instead right now. You know what I mean? There's not going to be selection headaches. I suppose you're going to talk about Gabriel or Martinelli if he's you know, recovered from what looks like a very minor sprain. But yeah, you know what, we've had to do it the hard way. We've got the job done. It's another victory. I'm really happy that Aubameyang scored as well, because
he needed it,
and you could tell by the smile on his face at the end of the game. It was probably a massive relief to just get that off his shoulders and say, right, now let's kick on. I think Oba knows himself that he's not had a great season to date. And what he needs now is a bit of luck as well, a bit of form, and just get himself going. And that, a tap-in, is what we've been saying for weeks he needs. He needs a tap-in. Just an ugly goal. Get it over the line. Get yourself going again for the season. And at the end of the day, we didn't do it easy last year in the third round. We struggled at times against Leeds United. But ultimately, we went all the way and won the trophy, and we're very good in the FA Cup. You need to have a bit of luck along the way. You need to have good draws as well, I suppose. But ultimately, yeah, I think this has kind of put us in good stead for when we play Newcastle in a week's time, because it kind of says to us, this is how Newcastle are going to play. There's no way Newcastle are going to play us in the Premier League and do anything different from what I saw today.
And that's how they've been playing. They've been playing like that all season. And when I've done the preview with Matty from the Magpie channel, he said to me, that's how they've been playing. The fans, their fans have been very, very frustrated at the way they play, because basically that's what they do. They put everybody behind the ball, low blocks, come and break us down. And hopefully they get a set piece or something. And they, you know, and sometimes it's worked. And, you know, we... You know, if they had it had been a league game, they would have got a point. You know what I mean? So, you know, it's we've got to be on the front foot from early in that game, but it's another win for this team and the confidence is rising.
It is. At the end of the day, it's four wins in a row. And, you know, if we would have spoke about that before the Chelsea game, you know, I would have been called Ty again. like everyone's been saying for the last few weeks that I'm delusional and everything. And I said, look, things will turn out eventually, and we need to get to January. We need to get that first victory and get ourselves on a bit of a run and get some momentum and some confidence within the players. And we've started that. There's no excuses now. We've got four wins on the bounce, three in the Premier League. We've got a good chance against Crystal Palace on Thursday. Again, it's going to be another tough game. They've got players that I feel could be more dangerous and you know, than what Newcastle are, with the likes of Zaha and Ezri, or you know, there's loads of, you know, dangers there. But it's another opportunity to get a win, make it five, then go into the Newcastle game. Let's try and make it six. And then we hit a real tough period, you know. And that's all we can do at the moment. Take it game by game, step by step, and see what happens in this window as well.
Okay, let me just get your thoughts before we go on Ozil. That's been more or less announced well, just before the game, which is a bit funny. That he's on his way to he's going to be leaving to go to Fenerbahce. Your thoughts on that?
I wish him well. I think that it's best for everybody. I've already, you know, gone into detail over this with you, and I'm not one of these that's going to disrespect him. I love the guy. I thought that some of the things he did at this football club were unbelievable, and I always rate him as a player. But the last 2 years have been very stale and very underwhelming, should we say. And I feel that, you know, there's been a lot of bad in the last couple of years that outweigh anything good. So it's the best for all parties. It's best for Mesut, you know, clean slate. He's been here for 7 odd years, won trophies. Gave the fans some good times. Let's remember those good times. And I wish him well in Turkey. And, you know, that's it. I can't really say much more than that. I wish him well. And I feel that it's the best for Arsenal Football Club. It's time to move on. You know, out with the old, in with the new. And we're starting to clear those players and get rid of, you know, the dead wood and whatnot. And long may it continue. And let's continue to grow.
All right, DT, thanks very much.
Pleasure, man.
This video is supported by Profit Accumulator. Profit Accumulator helps you to earn extra money by doing something called match betting. Match betting isn't gambling. And when you do it properly, and I mean properly, you can't lose. Now, you always see these promotions by bookmakers like Ladbrokes, William Hills, Corals, offering a £50 bonus to customers. So you sign up and you might place a £50 bet on a coin toss landing on heads and a £50 bet on the same coin toss landing on tails. Now, whichever way it lands, it don't matter because you won't win or lose any money because you've covered all of the outcomes. However, you get the £50 bonus, so you're still £50 up. Now, lots of people try to do match betting on their own, but it's very time consuming and not always easy if you don't know what you're doing. That's where Profit Accumulator come in. Even if you don't know anything about sports, they walk you through everything step by step, showing you how to accumulate money into your bank account. So get involved right now. Click the link in the description and sign up to Profit Accumulator right now.